It's time for evolution. We welcome you to the Ogono Art Family. Today, I'm going to be covering the topic of, can comics be considered manga? Can manga be considered comics? Can cartoons be considered anime? Can anime be considered cartoons? And so when we look in terms of language translation, manga is just the Japanese way of expressing the idea of how to say the word comic, but in the Japanese version of it, in the Japanese language, similar to cartoons, which translates to anime in Japanese. And if you were to retranslate manga or anime into English, it would retranslate back into cartoons and comics. So in that sense, they are the same thing. And so when it comes to the American comic or the Japanese manga, what ties them together is the fact that they are comics. However, what makes them differ is the culture backgrounds and the styles that are shown. To be more specific in the description, I'd say I'd use terms like Western comics versus Eastern comics. And so in a Western perspective, we have the superhero versus villain cartoon. We have, you know, cartoons made for comedic purposes or parody, or we have cartoons made for educational purposes, like for children, like Dora the Explorer. So that's the idea of the Western idea of comic and cartoons. And so Western comics and cartoons mainly target children to teenagers. However, when we go to Eastern comics, their demographic targets children all the way to adults. And so this is where we can have, you know, very adult themes in manga and anime. And these adult themes don't have to be, you know, violence or anything like that. I don't consider that, you know, adult themes. They may be considered in the category of the mature theme, but however, when I consider adult themes, I'm taking into consideration the intellectual aspect I get from watching a anime or manga or a Eastern comic. And now, to get back into the Western idea, when I see movies and films, these are mainly targeted towards teenagers to adults. However, I never see a movie that's targeted towards children that's in theaters or so. Actually, I changed my mind. There are some films that are targeted towards children to teenagers, like The Incredibles or Frozen. However, I haven't seen a cartoon that specifically targets an adult audience, like how Japan does it with their Eastern cartoons. Which is why I feel the mass people of Western believe that, you know, cartoons are made for children, because cartoons haven't been seen as the way Japan or, you know, Eastern cartoons have portrayed cartoons, because not only do they make cartoons for, you know, children, they also target adults as well. And there's also this idea among older people mainly that fantasy equates to something that's for children. So there's a Western fantasy television series called Game of Thrones. And if you've seen Game of Thrones, it speaks about love, politics, religion. It's a very adult theme kind of show. And now imagine if Game of Thrones was a anime. It'll still be targeted towards adults, even though it has a Eastern cartoon type of theme. And due to the Eastern cartoon adult themes, this is why we have artists that draw these themed like cartoons in a hyper-realistic or a semi-realistic kind of way when it comes to portraying their adult themed art. And so if it were drawn in a simplistic style, it may not be taken as seriously. And so I remember as a child, I'd stay up until 12 to wait for Adult Swim to start. And on Adult Swim, there was this Eastern cartoon called Paranoia Agent, which was targeted towards adults. And so when I had to watch this show, I'd enjoy the theme song. However, when the show started, I'd have no idea what was going on. And now as an adult, Now 24, I watched it when I was 23, and as I was watching it, it got me lost. I was still lost. Like, I was lost at episode 7. But, you know, you get the idea of what was going on. At least I got the idea that mass hysteria was being played, and it's a show that displays people's fears and people's dark psyches, so to say. So this show can be very abstract. So tell me down below in the comments what you think about manga and comics. Do you feel that they're different? Do you feel that they're similar? You know, share with me your ideas. And peace out.